Today we'll discuss about forced vital capacity, which is also known as timed vital capacity. Let us start with the definition. What is forced vital capacity? It is the volume of air that can be expired rapidly with maximum force following maximum inspiration. So here, vital capacity, which is expired rapidly. Forced vital capacity is dynamic lung capacity. Here, volume of air which is expired, that is timed. It is timed by recording this vital capacity on the spirograph, moving at a known speed. Now, we'll discuss about components of FVC. It has three components, FEV1, FEV2 and FEV3. Now, let us discuss what is it. FEV1, that is volume of air that is expired in first second, here you can see, it is about 80% of total FVC. Suppose our FVC is about 4800 ml, then FEV1 is 80% of this 4800 ml, that is equal to about 3800 ml. Next is FEV2, that is forced expiratory volume in 2 seconds. It is the volume of air that is expired in first 2 seconds, that is from starting to second. Now, FEV2 is about 90% of FVC. Same thing as we have discussed. If our FVC is 4800 ml, then FEV2 is 90%, 90% of 4800 ml. FEV3, that is forced expiratory volume in 3 seconds. It is the volume of air which is expired in first 3 seconds and it is about 98% to 100%. What is the clinical application of forced vital capacity? It is useful to differentiate between obstructive and restrictive lung diseases. Now, here, this diagram shows normal FVC. You can see here, this is the maximum inspiration and this is the maximum expiration. Forced vital capacity, that is about 4.8 liters. And FEV1, that is 3.85 liters, that is equal to 80% of vital capacity. Now, this shows obstructive lung disease. Now, obstructive lung disease, like in bronchial asthma, there is obstruction to the airflow. So what happens when airflow is obstructed? Then FEV1 is reduced. You can see here FVC is 4.8 liters, but FEV1, because of obstruction, 80% of the air is not expired in 4 seconds, so FEV1 decreases in obstructive lung diseases. What happens in restrictive lung diseases like kyphoscoliosis or fibrosis, etc.? Here what happens, because of restriction, vital capacity, or you can say forced vital capacity itself, is reduced. You can see here it becomes 2.4 liters only. And FEV1, although it is also reduced, you can see here 2 liters. But this FEV1 is 80% of the reduced vital capacity. So you can say that FEV1 percentage is normal. So we can differentiate obstructive and restrictive lung diseases by this forced vital capacity as well as FEV1, FEV2 and FEV3. So this is all about forced vital capacity or timed vital capacity. Thank you.